Hi guys, this is Shariq and welcome to Globetrot with Arabic. As usual, this is going to be a Lebanese Arabic lesson. And when I say Lebanese, you know by now that it falls under the category of the Levantine dialect, which is spoken in Lebanon, Jordan, Palestine and Syria. So today was day one in my 30-day challenge courses with my students on Zoom. And we were talking about something really simple. I thought I'm going to share it with you and I'm going to talk about it because it's very useful to know. And I will try, really, I'll try, it's not a promise, but I'll try to upload at least a short lesson every day for 30 days with you guys. So I would be doing a 30-day challenge with my students on Zoom and a 30-day challenge with you guys on YouTube. Yalla, let's begin. So when somebody asks you in Lebanon, kifak or kifik, you can say nih, good, nih. But we also say a lot of times, meshe lhal, meshe lhal. Maybe you know this by now, meshe lhal. But if you break meshe lhal down, what does it literally mean? The word meshe is a participle. In Arabic, a participle is ism fa'il, a participle. So meshe lhal. So meshe literally means walker, or the person who walks, or the thing that walks. And the word ilhal, hal means situation. Ilhal means the situation. Of course, I'm not going to say meshe and then pause and then say il and then pause and then say ilhal. No, I'm saying it all with a liaison. Meshe ilhal. You would be literally saying the situation is a walker, which then means the situation is walking. You're kind of using it as a present continuous. It plays the role of a verb, but it's not a verb, it's a participle. But you mean to say like, all good, yeah, it's fine. Like, it's not good, not bad. Like, it's okay, it's all right. You know, it's going good, maybe you say, or how do you say it in English? I don't know, like, okay. So, meshe lhal, you know what I mean. Like, you're not saying good, you're not saying bad. You can say mnih, which is good, but you can also say meshe lhal. It doesn't matter if you're a guy or a girl. The answer is always meshe lhal. So if I say to you as a guy, kifak, you say meshe lhal. And in Lebanon, we say a lot the two together in French as well. Ça va, meshe lhal, ça va. And if I'm asking a girl, kifik, she will say the same thing. Meshe lhal, ça va. But then something came up in class and the students were a bit confused. Does it mean like, I'm all right, it's okay? Or does it mean something else? So we saw the instead of meshe lhal, we saw in the sentence byemshe lhal, and it was a question, byemshe. So if we think about it now, we said that meshe is a participle and it means the walker, literally. Now byemshe means literally he walks. It's the present tense, byemshe. Okay, masalan, let's say baye byemshe kel yom, my father walks every day. Baye byemshe kel yom. Now that byemshe, when I put it with alhal, byemshe alhal, and I asked as a question, it doesn't mean all good. If somebody says, how are you? You say, yeah, I'm all right, I'm okay. No, it means, would that work for you? Is it okay for you? Byemshe alhal. So for example, let's say we were talking actually about booking a table in a restaurant, and let's say the person wanted to book for 9 p.m. and the waiter says, we don't have a table at 9 p.m. but we have a table at 8 p.m. Would that work for you? Would that work for you? Like sentence or question. In Lebanon, we say byemshe lhal. Byemshe lhal. Literally, you're saying, does the situation walk? Of course, you don't mean no situation walking, no nothing like that. You're just saying, would that work for you? Byemshe lhal. Now, there's a third way of using this. If you're using it in the past tense, you see? So just changing the tense is not only changing the tense, but it's also changing the meaning totally. So using a participle means like, I'm all right, all good. Using the present tense, you're saying like, would that work for you? Or maybe even as an answer to someone, you can say, hey, byemshe lhal, yeah, that works. Byemshe lhal, that works. Now the third one, if I use it in the past tense, meshe lhal. So you see, it's not meshe lhal. So the meshe lhal, notice there is a meme and an alif, but in Lebanon we pronounce it e, meshe lhal. But then there is meshe lhal, it's meme shin ye, and there is a kasra under the meme, meshe lhal. So not meshe lhal. You see the difference? The first one is, hear it, meshe lhal, that's long. The second one is meshe lhal, and meshe is a verb, it's not a participle, and it's in the past tense. Meshe means he walked. So for example, I can say Baye meshe lyon. My father walked today. Baye meshe lyon. Literally, just he walked in the past tense. But when I say it with الحال, meshe الحال, I don't mean like a situation walked. No, not like that. I mean to say, okay, it's sorted. It worked now. So for example, if you had a problem and you asked, I don't know, your friend to fix your computer, and then you notice, oh, it works now. And you say, خلاص مش الحال, مش الحال. It's sorted. It works now. Or maybe he fixed it for you and he says to you, يلا, you can use it now, مش الحال. Okay? مش الحال. So anytime there was an issue, a small issue or a big issue, it doesn't matter, a small problem or a big problem, if you want to say خلاص, يعني خلاص means that's okay, it's done and it's sorted, you can say مش الحال, or you can say خلاص مش الحال. يعني خلاص and مش الحال, kind of you're using them together, although خلاص means enough, but you don't mean enough here, it's you're just saying like, yeah, that's fine, مش الحال. Okay, so it's sorted, مش الحال. So now we have three sentences. I'm going to repeat them for you and keep them in your mind so that you can also use them in the future and say them with me so that the pronunciation sticks in your mind. So the first one is ماشي الحال. So if I say to you, كيفك, for example, John, كيفك John, you can say ماشي الحال. And if I want to ask you, would that work for you? بيمشي الحال. And if you want to say, yeah, that works for me, hey, بيمشي الحال. And the third one would be, okay, خلاص, it's sorted. Let's say my computer doesn't need any fixing anymore. It's sorted. خلاص, مش الحال. You can just say مش الحال, or you can say خلاص, مش الحال. That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed it. And I'm gonna see you maybe tomorrow with another lesson. Bye now.